Good day, students. Welcome to part one of our differentiation flashcards. We're going to be going over formulas 1 through 6 in this review installment. More clips can be found on math.serve.com. For AP Calculus students, you can go to math.serve.com under AP Calculus to gain access to a wide variety of great tutorials. So let's go ahead and take a look at the first formula. Now, before we start, I'd like to go over some critical components of this flashcards so that you can basically know the orientation or where I position certain things. On the upper left corner is the name of the function that we're going to be learning the differentiation formula for. On the upper right corner, we have the orientation of the card. Is either the front or the back? And then on the lower right corner, you have the number assigned to each index card, okay? For these flashcards I'm going over, we're going to be going from flashcard 1 all the way to 6. All right, moving right along. The first formula we are going to deal with, the constant function. It says d dx of c. So d dx is basically a notation, one of the notations for differentiation. So the way you read this is also provided below. You see here it says read, the way it's read is the derivative of a constant. So d dx represents an operation, the differentiation process. So this, the front of this card is asking you the derivative d dx of a constant c is what? So that's how you read it, okay? And the answer is on the reverse. Let's flip the card. So the derivative of a constant function c is equal to 0. Okay. I'll also be providing examples on the reverse side of each index card to help you associate the formula with a concrete situation or example. So let's take a look at an example of the case that represents the constant function differentiation rule. So an example is d dx of pi. We know that pi is a constant, is an irrational number, so it qualifies as c. So this example helps us to see that the derivative d dx of pi is equal to 0. All right, let's take a look at the next formula. This is the constant multiple rule, formula number 2. So it says d dx of c times f of x. So what this formula basically is representing is the derivative of a constant multiplied by a function. What is the derivative of a constant multiplied by a function? So the derivative of a constant multiplied by a function is equal to c times the d dx of f of x. So what this formula is telling us in essence is that a constant multiple of a function can be factored out from the argument that you're differentiating. So on the left side, you can, you're differentiating this entire expression, c times a function, where c is a constant. The constant multiple rule tells you that that c can be factored out, and then you just focus on differentiating the function using whatever differentiation rule you want to apply. All right, so that's the main idea here. So let's take a look at an example. What is the derivative of 3 times tan x? In this situation, tan x is a function and 3 is a constant c. So this example helps us to see that it's the same thing as 3 multiplied by the derivative of tan x. In the upcoming installment, I will be going over what the derivative of trig functions are. That's why I didn't simplify this all the way, because we do not know what the derivative of tan is. So just remember, the constant multiple rule gives you the rights to factor out constants that are being multiplied to a function before you differentiate. And then after differentiation, of course, do not forget to multiply the constants that you factored out with your derivative. Okay, let's take a look at formula number 3. formula three is the power rule, okay? So what is the power rule? Power rule tells us that the derivative of x raised to the nth power, the derivative of x raised to the nth power, so the answer, the derivative of x raised to the nth power is equal to n times x raised to the n minus 1, all right? So basically, you take the power, you power it down, multiply the function, but you reduce the power of the term that had the power originally by 1. So n x to the n minus 1 is the derivative of x to the nth power, okay? Now let's take a look at an example here. The question is, what is the derivative of 5x to the third power? Now, to find this derivative, I made use of one of the formulas that we covered before, which is the constant multiple rule. You can see it in action here because I factored out the 5, and then I focused on differentiating this power function right here, x to the third. Now, applying the power rule to x to the third, what am I supposed to do? I power down this exponent, so this 3 comes down here. You have it as 5 times 3. And then you subtract the power, you subtract 1 from the power. So you have 5 times 3, x to the 3 minus 1. Okay, so take a look at this formula right here. And then I'll take a look at this. Hopefully you can see that this is n, and this is n minus 1, because in this problem, n is equal to 3. So if you multiply 5 times 3, you have 15x to the second power. So this is an example that involves the incorporation of the constant multiple rule and the power rule. As you deal with more and more complicated functions in calculus, you will have to often differentiate a function by making use of multiple rules. All right, let's take a look at the next formula. This is a sum and difference rule. So it tells us that the derivative of the sum or difference of two functions is equal to the derivative of the functions that you're adding or subtracting from each other. So the derivative of the first function u plus or minus the derivative of the second function, v. All right, so that's basically what the sum and difference rule represents. All right, so let's take a look at an example. So this problem says, what is the derivative of x to the third plus 7x plus 4? So we have a sum of three terms here. So we apply the sum and difference rule. What that enables us to do is to take the derivative of the individual terms that have been added together here. In this result, I skipped some steps. So let's go ahead and go over that real quick. So the derivative of x to the third, you apply the power rule. You power down 3 and subtract 1 from 3. We have 3x squared. The derivative of 7x, you factor out 7 from x, and then this is x to the first power. When you apply the power rule to x to the first power, you power down 1 times x to the 1 minus 1, and 1 minus 1 is 0, x to the 0th power is 1, so you're left with 7. This, the differentiation of 7x shows you one really cool trick that you can memorize. When you're differentiating functions of this nature, first degree terms, all you have to do is drop the variable, and the constant is always the derivative. For example, think about y equals mx plus b. M is a slope. It can be thought of as a derivative also. So when you're dealing with mx, anything of that nature, the derivative of mx is just m. So in this case, if we have 7x, think about 7 as a slope, and this is x. So the derivative of 7x is just 7. That's a good shortcut that you can always use. What is the derivative of 4? Think about the first rule we went over, that is the constant function rule. Remember, the derivative of a constant is 0, so you don't have any zeros here. So I skipped a lot of steps deliberately to challenge you. If you don't understand this, you can get out a sheet of paper and work out all the details, and you get 3x squared plus 7. So this is an example of the sum and difference rule. All right, next rule, let's take a look at the product rule. This tells us that the derivative of the product of two functions, u and v, see what the answer is. So the derivative of u and v is equal to u v prime. Wait a minute, what is going on here? Well, prime is another notation for representing the derivative. If you're writing an expression that involves taking a lot of derivatives, instead of writing d dx over and over again, prime is a condensed way of expressing the derivative. So what is the d dx of uv, which is the same thing as uv prime? It's v u prime plus uv prime. That's the same thing as saying v times the derivative of u, d dx of u, plus u times d dx of v. All right, so you see the benefit of the prime notation. It helps simplify things. Instead of writing d dx, sometimes that could be messy, so using the prime notation could be very beneficial. So that's the product rule for u. Now let's apply it to an example. D dx of x squared sine x, do you see two functions here? I have the power function x squared and the trig function sine x. So the function that comes second is v. Think about alphabetical order, uv. U comes before v. So the function that comes second is v and the first function is u. Applying the product rule, we have v, the second function, times u prime, the derivative of the first, plus u, the first function, times the derivative of the second. We haven't gone over the differentiation rules for trig functions, so I'm just going to stop here just to illustrate how the product rule can be applied. Well, let's take a look at the last set of formulas. And this is a quotient rule. So d dx of u over v, the function in the numerator is u, and the function in the denominator is v. So the derivative of d dx of u over v, which is the same thing as u over v prime, remember prime represents the derivative, is equal to v u prime minus u v prime over v squared. All right, so that's the quotient rule there for u. So let's take a look at an example of the quotient rule. So we have the derivative of x over ln x is equal to v, which is ln x, the denominator function, times the derivative of u, which is a numerator function, x, minus u, which is x, times the derivative of the denominator, ln x prime, over the denominator, ln x squared. So this result can be simplified further, but since we haven't gone over the derivative of ln x, natural logarithm of x, yet, I'm just going to stop here. I will be going over the derivative of ln x in the upcoming installments. And also another point to note is that v, the denominator function, cannot be zero. I just wanted to throw in a mnemonic device that some use to remember the quotient rule. Personally, I don't really understand how it's beneficial, but a lot of students like it, so I thought it would be good to share it. So d in this mnemonic device represents the derivative, high represents the function on the top, and low represents the function on the bottom. The top is u, the bottom is v. So you just say high, I made a slight mistake here. So it's low, which is the denominator function, v, the high, the derivative of the numerator function, u prime, minus high, which is the numerator function u, d low, the derivative of the low of the function in the denominator, v prime, divided by low square, which is v square. So students just say low d high minus high d low over low square. That's how they remember the quotient rule, but I like this format better. V square I mean, vu prime minus uv prime over v squared. So whichever one helps you remember the quotient rule, that'll be great. Another way to make use of this tutorial is you can copy them down, just make flashcards for yourself, and then you just flip through them over and over again, and then you should be able to memorize all your differentiation formulas. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We appreciate it. Do subscribe to our channel so you can get updates to the remaining flashcards for remembering the differentiation rules. Please post a comment to let us know what you think about this presentation. And do give us a thumbs up if you liked it. And also don't forget to share it with your friends. More clips can be found on math.serve.com, as indicated earlier. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.